Now, historically, you had to buy before something good happens and then sell into the news. The smart money always loaded up and crushed bids when stories broke, often leading to big losses for anyone who bought the news. I should say anyone uninformed enough to buy the news. Not this market, though. The new pattern is insane. If you got experience, it works against you. That's right, because it's making fortunes for the newcomers, for the new people who are investing. And I salute it. Let me give you some examples. They're classic. Okay, let's start with Nucor. That's the nation's best and largest steelmaker. Now, we own this one for the Charitable Trust. We've written bulletin after bulletin about how Nucor could be a big winner from the passage of any infrastructure bill. But the stock's been very tough to own. And if you tried to trade it, you got clobbered. Now, I've been defending Nucor as the best and cheapest way to play a recovery in auto sales and construction. I didn't even bother thinking about the infrastructure bill anymore because analyst after analyst downgraded the stock, arguing that the good news on the infrastructure front was already baked in, so forget about it. These professionals would have been right if we had the same kind of institutionally dominated stock market that we've had for the past 20 years, but we don't. In the old days, once we found out that Congress had finally passed the infrastructure bill, you might have seen Nucor stock open up, say, a point or two before the heat-seeking sellers came in and lit up the buyers, taking furious profits. In the end, they might have blasted this thing down to below where it was a week ago. Oh, but this is a new market that's no longer totally dominated by big institutional money managers, not at all. Individual investors got the power. So when the bill actually passed, sellers were non-existent. Not since the opening, Nucor jumped 5 points. Now then, some selling came in, but rather than crushing the stock, more buyers came out to meet them, which is how Nucor ultimately finished the day up $4 or 3.6%. I got to tell you, I haven't seen anything like this individual investor movement since before the dot-com crash in 2000. It's been that long. Who's doing all the buying? I suspect it's you. The home gamers, or as they're derisively known on Wall Street, retail investors. Retail meaning nobody. Not on this show. Now the retail. You running circles around the professionals, and I salute you. See, Nucor was too obvious for the pros. Regular investors, the individual investors, they no doubt wanted to be sure the bill would actually pass before they pulled the trigger. Then they started buying hand over fist. And you know what? I don't even think they're finished.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com. Or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.